how you doing, my friend?
Michael, how are you? How was your weekend? 64.
I'm telling you, the weekend was great. And you know why the weekend was great? Because I knew this was episode 64.
Yes.
Officially, and I could be wrong, but the note takers, the legitimizers, the people who write the rules, the people who take the notes have just informed me that this number 64 has officially
eclipsed
the other podcast I had done a while ago. So I'm rather impressed with that. I think we should put a little golf clap here. A little golf clap.
Very nice.
I'm impressed. Yeah, exactly. Very nice, Muffin. So that's kind of cool. I'm really glad to hear that.
Yeah. It is good.
Listen, I know we made a deal not to talk about anything in the past, but what's your thoughts on surpassing, an old podcast that I did?
I personally think it's energy and positivity, and I think that wins.
You know what? Let's leave it there. I think you said it very positively, that it was positiveness that made it work. Yeah. So listen, before we get into anything else, I want to talk about a little something that happened to me this weekend. So this past weekend was President's Day's weekend, and my parents' birthday is the 20th and the 24th. Dad's is the 20th, mom's is the 24th. So we couldn't get our time to on their birthdays. I live down here, they're up there. So we celebrated a Saturday night at my brother's, who had a really rocking time. Put together a big dinner. The birthday cake was one of the best birthday cakes I ever had. And my father and I were talking about it the next morning. And lo and behold, in the refrigerator was like 9 containers of the birthday cake, because my brother won't eat sugar. Like he'll have a little bit to celebrate.
Right.
But, you know, he's always watching his figure, which is probably something I need to get back to myself. But anyways. Yeah.
Me too.
We all do. We all do. But anyways, it was really a fun time. So I had a couple days off, no tours. And I like to do this thing where I go back to my old stomping grounds, old apartment Sue and I lived in, the parks I used to play in, all that type of thing. So I did a whole bunch of videos for Instagram, and you can go check them out. It's fun. The Yo Philly Rock and Film Tour. Yes, they're a lot of fun. So Sunday afternoon, now my mother and father have a routine, and it's one I feel where I don't belong on a Sunday morning. My father sits in his chair, my mother sits on the couch, and they read the newspaper for about 9 hours.
Okay.
I don't know if there's nothing about Rocky in those newspapers for 9 hours. I'm lost. Okay.
Right.
That could be a reason. I'm not saying for sure, but more than likely why my parents are much more broad-minded and smarter than I am, because they probably read the local newspaper. Anyways, right. I thought, all right, here's a good time for me. I'm going to go out and just kind of, I don't know, get myself together. So Sue stayed at her mom's, and she said, hey, I'm putting breakfast on. Come on down. So I went down early to my mother-in-law's, had a nice breakfast, and then I made a decision that I thought at the end of the decision would have killed me. I made the decision to go to a place called Lake Scranton. Now, Lake Scranton is a 3.5 mile lake circumference. Okay? And I used to go up there all the time when I was in the police academy. I used to run it for training. That's where we got tested on our endurance and speed and so on. And it's beautiful. It looks like Rambo country. Lake Scranton does.
Oh, yeah, it does. Yeah,
it really does. Anyways, they even reference it in The Office. Very differently. But anyways, so I said to myself, well, I'm just going to walk maybe like, I don't know, 1,000 yards.
Right.
And the 1,000 yards turned into 3.5 miles. And by the time I crawled back up the side of the mountain where the parking lot is, my shins, I had shin splints. Back of my right knee, I had this pull that was going on. Mm-hmm. And I had something going on in my upper back and my elbow. And I thought, I was walking. How does my elbow hurt? And I thought, Jesus, this is quite humiliating. Anyways, I'm driving around, and I said to myself, there's one place I like to go in Scranton. It's called On and On. And it's basically a flea market, two floors, and there's a lot of Scranton paraphernalia in there. And I'm a big Scranton nut. In my room, I have pictures of Scranton and articles and so on.
Right.
It's my hometown. So I go in. I don't see anything on the first floor. And I was ready to leave. My legs hurt. That's why I didn't go to the second floor.
Oh.
And at the last minute, as I'm going to go reach for the door to leave, I said, you know what, Mike? Just for the hell of it, go upstairs. I go upstairs and there's a bunch of old blow molds. I don't know if you know what a blow mold is.
No.
All right. Do you ever see the old Santa Clauses? They're the hollow vinyl plastic and it's a light bulb.
Yes.
Right.
Yes. Okay.
The soldiers from the Nutcracker. Those are plastic blow molds from the 50s and 60s.
Got it.
They're all over up there and I love those. Sue hates blow molds. I wanted to get a bunch of them and put them around the house, but she said, no, that's not gonna happen.
Yeah.
I said, okay, fine. See, you don't love me. You don't support me.
Oh, poor Sue.
Right. Exactly.
I gotta call her.
Exactly. So I'm starting to lose my pep, and I'm gonna go home to take a nap at my mother's.
Yes.
And I look over my shoulder. Stacy, would you put up a picture of the Bonds logo, please?
Yes. There it is.
Okay. If you guys could just take a look at this for a few seconds while I tell you this. This label, it's Bonds Fifth Avenue. What does this have to do with the Rocky world? Well, this has been something I've been after for the better part of 45 plus years.
Yep.
A while back, I found out, a little less than 20 years ago, I found out where Sylvester Stallone bought his leather jacket. So when he was living in New York City, there was a store called Corvettes with a K. Mm-hmm. And it was Korean vets who put together the store. They were in Philly, up and down the East Coast.
Right.
And he bought this black, unique looking leather jacket at Corvettes. And, of course, in the original Rocky, there was no money for a wardrobe allowance, so Stallone had to wear his own clothes as Rocky. Because I don't know if you guys know this, but the original script, Rocky was wearing a peacoat, a navy peacoat. But he didn't have any money for a navy peacoat. Mm-hmm. So he had to wear what he had to wear. I found this one. And, Stacy, this is the one that's closed, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Okay. There you go. This imagine Sylvester Stallone going to Corvettes and he grabs the jacket and he walks up to this register and he buys it. This is the jacket behind it on the rack. Okay. This is identical in every way to the jacket he wears. And if you guys notice, and I know it's hard to see, but you'll see the lapel. There's this across the upper chest. It's this very unique lapel that's very hard to come by. And there's a bunch of other things about it. Anyways, so I found this on eBay for a couple hundred dollars a few years ago. Okay, you can take that one though. Thank you. I look over and I see the Bonds logo on a coat rack. It's just hanging there. And it's facing me. And I'm like, no.
No way.
No way. And I go over, I take the jacket off, and I look at it, and it's this jacket. It's identical. I could not believe it. So I'm going over it with the fine-tooth comb. So this is unreal. I can't believe it. I mean, it comes with the liner. It's got the logo on it. It's insane. Then I don't want to look at the price. And Sue gives me a wide breath ever since I lied to her about the championship belt at Olive Garden.
Right.
I have a wide breath for emergencies like this. There's a little emergency Rocky fund set aside.
Got it.
And I now have the confidence I don't need to ask, hey, can I take this out of the account? Just go get it if it's that rare.
Right.
$60. $60. For a Bonds Fifth Avenue Rocky replica. Couldn't believe it.
They didn't know what they had. They had no idea what they had. Wow.
After I bought it, I walk out the door and because I was like 10 feet away and I go, do you guys know the significance of this jacket? They didn't know. And I told them, I go, it's the same jacket that rocked, same exact style, same exact type. And they're like, okay, thanks for the business. Like, they didn't care. They didn't want to be there on a Sunday. They just wanted to go home. Anyways, I was so tired. The moral of the issue is perseverance. Keep moving forward, people. Don't give up. Anyways, Stacy, that was my time. What's been happening with you and the rest of the world as it was?
Well, we have actually a very busy Rocky Bubble community going on here. And so
Really?
So first, I just want to talk about Melissa Gilmore coming to Nashville. We had so much fun. This girl, I love Melissa so much. Let me pull up some pictures here. So here we are. There's a place called Acme Feed and Seed, and it's a restaurant at the bottom of Broadway and 2nd, right in Nashville, right on the busy part, which I tend to avoid just because the lines are crazy, but we happen to be there at a good time. So we got right in. The second floor is all couches and then little tables. And so here we are there just hanging out.
Look at that. Isn't that a great pic?
And so Melissa was just, she was just a ton of fun. And she had this book with her. Okay. I couldn't believe what I was seeing. So it's like a picture memory book. So she pulls this out. Okay. Wow. It's her picture on the front. And then as you go through it, her sister, Patrice, created this for her. It's her episode. Every page is her episode pictures, you know, and I was like, oh my gosh. I said, this is the most beautiful thing. So this is her sister. I just went and I met Patrice.
Aww.
Super sweet. Also met this young lady named Kaylee, who was Melissa's student of hers when she was in kindergarten, who goes to Belmont with Sarah now. So I got to meet her. She's a lovely, lovely young lady. But anyway, doesn't she hand it to me? And she says, oh, can you sign it? And I'm like, what? She's like, can you
is
sign it?
Is that your first autograph?
That is my first autograph. I couldn't believe it. And so Sarah's next to me. She's like videotaping the whole thing. I'm looking at Melissa like, what? I'm like, the only thing I've ever signed is a check to pay my bills.
Right.
So that was like the sweetest thing in the world. So I wrote a little note inside. It felt like I was signing a yearbook. But I just wanted to say we had such a fun time. And
What was she doing in Tennessee?
So her sister and her have birthdays that are really, really close together.
Okay.
And so they do something every year. So they just picked Nashville this year. And so she's like, oh, you got to come down. I'm like, of course I'm going to come down. So I came down. But she also got me something. And now you're not the only one who has it.
Yes. Oh, the ducky. Look at the ducky.
The rubber ducky.
I love it.
So she bought me this. I could not wait to show you.
She's okay. That Melissa's all right. I like her.
She got me a little, it's like a car air freshener.
All right. Wait a minute.
Wait a minute.
What does it smell like if you scratch it? And where are you scratching it? Jesus.
I don't know if it smells like the gym or like man baby powder.
Right? Okay. I wonder if it smells like Kuros. It was cologne Stallone used to wear. Kuros. He used to wear that back in the 90s, I believe.
Kuros. I have to look that up. Hmm.
Yeah, it didn't. I don't know. I smelled it once. It wasn't all that great.
So that, remember how we talked about this puzzle that she was going to send me a puzzle to put together?
I believe.
Okay, so I want to scold whoever sold this to her. Okay, so I'm trying to put this puzzle together.
Okay.
It's only about maybe 50% of the pieces are there. We lay them all out. I'm trying to put together, like we get the necklace together. I get his eyes together. As we're going, Kevin's helping me do it. As we're like, we lay out all the straight pieces. There's no corner pieces. There's no straight pieces. It's easily 50% missing. So whoever you are a bad man.
are they missing or are they just invisible?
Oh, yes.
My mother puts puzzles together, and she does invisible puzzles after a few drinks, but she does invisible puzzles.
So well,
say that 12 times fast.
Yeah, we didn't buy – Melissa didn't buy invisible pieces.
she didn't get them.
No, she wanted whole pieces. I was like
– But who does that? Who puts a puzzle – together. What was that? Like a baggie that they had the picture
in? Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's just, they sent it to her like this, and then the pieces are here.
Right. And there's enough of them to naturally assume, yep. Oh, this could probably be sure.
And okay. The other thing I'm thinking, maybe the puzzle's not as big as the picture itself. Well,
that was right after Rambo 3, by the way.
It's half the picture. I was like, so is there, not is cool. There,
you know what? Let's sue. Let's get, who's a good lawyer? We can get, who was Kramer's lawyer in Seinfeld? Remember the coffee? And then, right, let's keep right on going because that'll waste way too much time. Jackie Childs, did you put the top of the coffee? You didn't put the top on the coffee.
Oh, yes. I remember that. Yes.
You're hot, but not too hot. Giddy up.
I remember that. I do remember that. All right.
I can't believe a puzzle would exist like that. Someone did that. Man, this is
like,
a special...
what's the point? Like, really? Like, come on. Just, I don't know.
They're going right to hell.
They are.
They are.
So, you know how spoiled we are with Sly Stallone Shop and how easy it is to get things and sure. stuff like that. So, our friend Raminder out in India it's hard to get stuff in India.
Okay.
Like, you can't, they don't ship to India. I don't think Amazon ships to India. I don't know if eBay does. You just can't get Rocky stuff anywhere. So I don't know if it was in his town or somewhere nearby, found a guy who is a custom shoemaker. And look at this. Look what he had created for himself. Okay.
Oh, holy Christ.
His goal was to have these shoe made that showed the most important people in Rocky's life. Wow. Plus all the villains.
Right.
You know, everyone he fought. So I just wanted to show these off. I'm like, if this isn't some impressive Rocky love right here. And this is what I love about him. All his t-shirts he's ever gotten, he's had to have custom done. It's like, don't tell me I can't have Rocky stuff. I'm going to get it done one way or the other. Yeah. And these are his shoes. Just love them.
You've got to send me. When you do edits and everything and you get it up, you've got to send me this one. Well, however long this little clip is, I got to post that. People are going to love that.
Yeah.
That's a diehard fan right there. Raminder, way to go, my friend. Way to go.
So I just wanted to show those. He sent them to me, and I hadn't posted it yet, and I'm sure he was wondering why, but I wanted to surprise him.
Oh, definitely post. Definitely.
Yeah. So we'll post after. Let's see. And then, of course, it's Adrian Month here, and I just love what I'm getting in. So here is Larry and his wife. Aren't they out? They met Frank Stallone.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. And they – oh, gosh, where's their picture? Don't tell me I lost it. I'll insert it. So here's their picture. And what I love.
Oh, look how cute. Awesome?
So they're out there in the world dressed like Adrian and Rocky. And I just loved that. And I just wanted to thank them for sending that my way. So sweet. And then Brock, we know Brock. And this is his wife, Sean. For Valentine's Day, their local theater was playing Rocky 2.
Where to go, guys?
Yes. And so he took her out there. I was like, oh my gosh, all these were nice romantic men. So that was so sweet.
Looks like even Brock got dressed up there.
What? Let's look at him again. What
let's take a look at that. Oh, just a white t-shirt. Sorry, Brock.
We love t-shirts.
Brock, I'm sorry. I'm goofing on you because that was kind of funny. That's the first thing that came to my mind.
Well, no, you can.
You look great.
You can goof on him. Let me tell you, my husband and I, they came through Nashville. My husband and I went to dinner with them, you know, a couple months ago. And oh my God, he's a tease. I mean, he is
constantly teasing
everybody at the table, so he can take it. Absolutely.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. Yeah, wives are generally known to be goof proof, you know, but like guys, nah, no way. We're fair game.
Right. And then I wanted to take time to insert this video of Lorenzo and his Girl Scout. I'm going to put it in right here. Look what he did.
Girls, the numbers just don't add up. We've got to do better. We can do this. Just think, hard work pays off. We just need an idea.
Remember that look in your eyes? Last year, you sold hard, and you won. You gotta get that look back. And the only way to get that look back is to go back to the beginning. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah!
I, the tiger. I, the tiger. Come on, 2-1952! Yeah!
Come on!
Is that not the best idea? I just love the way he sort of recreated that moment and then made this whole Rocky video trying to, you know, cheer them on.
That's great.
And just, and he wanted Sly to know that this entire Rocky, this, you know, this Girl Scout group is very Rocky inspired, as if they, you know, had a choice with Lorenzo there. But still, you know, he's really inserting that Rocky attitude and that Rocky philosophy with this group.
Oh, my God, yeah.
And just made the cutest video ever.
So let's see. Lorenzo is, I don't know what he's bigger at. Is he bigger and better at a dad or the Rocky fan? Because he's epic on both.
Yeah, you know, it's true. And he brings it together, and he's, you know, it's kind of like Tony D with his kids too.
Right.
You
know, like
great dads and big Rocky philosophy in the family. They're very similar in that way. And I did want to say congratulations to Tony D now that he came up. He did get a post from Sly this past week, a repost. So that was really exciting because he's really, really fighting for Sly and his Rocky rights. And so I was just happy to see that Sly acknowledged all his effort around that. That was very nice.
There you go.
Let's see a few more things. We got a lot going on. I still have a few more things here now.
It's been a busy week.
It has been a busy
week. We need like a traffic light.
All right.
Stuff going on all the time.
I know. So as you know, I've been putting out video requests. You know, it's Adrian month, and I've been saying, hey, ladies, let me know, why do you love Adrian? And what does she mean to you? What have you learned? Well, don't I get one from Jason Nike, who is, he used to be called J-Man's Movie Cave. He changed his brand over to Backtrack Cinema. And he sent us this lovely video. Let me just pull this up.
Hey, guys, my name is Jason from Backtrack Cinema. So why I love Adrian? I love Adrian because of her real quiet strength and how she's always looking out for the best for Rocky. I mean, that's really what it's all about with her. And I love the character arc she goes on from being this real mousy, shy, introverted woman who ends up being a real, real fighter, a big fighter, in fact. Remember the beach scene in Rocky III, how she, you know, brings Rocky, not only Apollo who brought Rocky back, it was Adrian. And in Rocky V, the strength she has in that movie, that's very much an Adrian movie. And, you know, she has felt every punch, every pain, every fight he's gone through, she felt it too. And she just, they're just a perfect couple. Love Adrian. She is Rocky's rock. Keep on punching.
Isn't that sweet? Nice. I love that. So I'm going to be opening up the video clips to the gentleman. I don't know.
Oh, really?
Yes, I am. I'm not going
to be. We're going to be allowed to participate?
Female.
Because I had something to say, but I was like, well, I don't want to step on Stacy's toes. She said girls only, which is sexist, and I'm thinking about suing ourselves.
Right.
But whatever.
Report me to HR, which I'm the head of.
All right. You are the head of HR. Kind of screwed on that one.
Yeah. So anyway, but Jason, thank you. That was so nice. And I
did a good job. Definitely. Yeah,
it's so nice. And if there are any other gentlemen out there who want to send me in, you know, a little clip like that, I will post it on Instagram. So that was very nice. And
one quick addendum. Let's say there's a podcast out there and one of the co-hosts has a wife, but let's say she's so busy with work, but let's say she really wants to do something. And then let's say it might not get done until March. Would it be grandmothered in under the time constraints?
Anything Sue does will be entered at any time.
Not Sue. Asking for a friend.
Yeah. All you know what? Any Adrian message goes anytime.
All right. I'll pass that on.
Yes. But yes, it's so funny you say that because I messaged you about that. I'm like, hey, is Sue going to send us one? Because everyone loves Sue. I mean, every comment about Sue is always so positive and people would love to hear her.
I know. They want to know what meds she's on to deal with me.
Yeah.
How do you deal with this?
I didn't say it. All right. So this right here, I made a purchase. Don't tell my husband.
No, come on. Uh-oh.
Yeah. John Rivoli
is a Rivoli if ever there was one. Look at that.
Now, I'm going to cut it in. I'll cut it in right here, but the video that went along with this, I'm like, is he trying to kill me with that music? The music matched the vibe so perfectly. Yeah. I think I watched it 10 times in a row. That was, and I love all his posts, but that was one of the most beautiful posts. Just want to tell folks, it's the month of February, the month of love, and what better than a Rocky piece? But yeah, so this is he's offering it in 12 by 12 and it's $40. And so go to iconsinart.com. Absolutely can't wait for this piece to come in.
I just ordered mine this morning for Sue. She saw it and I was somewhere and she texted me and she goes, "You got to get me John's love painting." And I said, "Okay." So I bought it this morning and I was a little disappointed that John's only offering it in a 12 by 12. Mm. I was going to get it in a 9 foot by 12 right? foot, and I was going to put it on Sue's bedroom wall.
Right. But you're going to have to commission him. You're going to have to.
Whatever.
You have to ask him to do that somehow.
About to sell several kidneys.
Then my last announcement, Mr. Rocco now has his book. Now I have the paper cover, but he is now offering it in hardcover.
Wow.
And so I believe it's over on Amazon. And if not, I'll correct it in a comment here at the bottom of the screen, but it is now in hardcover. And I was just such a young man. I just love entrepreneurial young people.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So just wanted to let people know if they want it in hardcover, you can get it from him. And he is on Rocky Trivia Book 2022 on Instagram. So
beautiful.
That is our Rocky bubble as of right now.
Stacy, thanks. It's been great.
It's been good. Going.
I got to get out of here.
No.
I got to go make some chicken marsala. Wait.
Wait.
Do it. Is there some?
It's the return.
Uh-oh, who's at the door, Stacy?
The return of Roz. Hang on. Boom.
Hey.
Hey, Roz.
I was like, you ain't going nowhere.
How are you, Roz? I'm so happy that we could arrange this, you know, as the month of Adrian. And Adrian was a fighter. And you, my friend, I just want you to jump right into it. You were with us. You were episode 9, am I right?
Yes, I was episode 9.
So this is a long time ago. Wow. Long time
ago.
I
know, right?
One of our, original top 10. And we were impressed with you then. You took the COVID time to lose 100 pounds. You were running. You were unbelievable. That story alone was like, as I've said it 1,000 times, you're the only person on earth who lost weight during that time. But then since then, your 2022 has not been easy. And so I wanted to give you a moment to tell us about this latest fight that you've been battling.
Oh, gosh. Yes. Yeah. It's like, you know, they try to knock me down, but I keep getting back up. It's like the Rocky and Adrian spirit. Exactly. In May of 2022, I was diagnosed with stage 1 ovarian cancer. Mm-hmm. So, you know, when you hear cancer, it's like a super scary word. And so I just took everything I learned from the movies and just I already had it in my head, like, no matter what happens, I'm gonna fight. Mm-hmm. But I'm so glad that you're doing the Adrian Month now, because don't get me wrong, I've loved Adrian, but I've never appreciated her more. Yeah. Because I feel that she also had cancer. Yep. And if I'm not mistaken, I mean, Rocky says it's woman cancer, so mm-hmm. I'm assuming that it's also ovarian cancer as well.
Yep, that is true.
Mm-hmm. And I just, like, all her strength and her femininity and everything, I wish we got to see her fight.
Yeah.
But it doesn't matter. Like, Rocky implied that she put up one hell of a fight. And, you know, when he's telling Donnie, you know, like, this fight, I've seen it before, and it's, you know, it's super hard, and it doesn't, you know, it's the toughest fight you'll ever have. And it just made me, like, dig deep and mm-hmm. just say, like, I can do this. Yeah. I can. I'm still in the middle of it. Thank God, like, the surgery took care of it. I'm in remission right now. So mm-hmm. I have to go for surveillance exams every 3 months. Right. But for the most part, thank God, everything yeah. is working out the way it should be.
Right.
But it's heavy. Like, and again, like, getting back to Adrian, like, the scene on the beach in Rocky 3, like, mm-hmm. you know, Rocky's afraid, and, you know, I was afraid, and...
Oh, it's okay, sweetheart.
I knew I was gonna cry.
It's okay, sweetheart. This is what it is. No, this is what it is. This is real, like, stuff.
My dad, he always loves to quote that scene to me on the beach with Adrian, sure. saying, like, you know, you're human, aren't you? Like, it's okay to be afraid, but you still gotta fight.
Yeah.
So that's what I did. I just dug my heels in and I fought.
And
Roz, I gotta say something here. Something, you said something that was very profound. And I don't know if anybody watching right now heard that or caught that. You said, I took everything I learned from the movies. Not from Dr. WebMD, not from anything from Rocky. I assume that's what you meant from yeah. the Rocky yes. series, right? You took all of that motivation, that fear, and you worked it to your advantage. You used the inspiration from the character of Rocky, what Rocky and Adrian went through. Yeah. And yeah, how can that help you get through this obstacle course and challenge you must now face? And I think that speaks to several reasons. That's why we do the podcast. That's why you're back here again, because it's this power of the character of Rocky that yeah. can help people get through one of the worst times of their lives. Cancer.
Yeah. yeah.
And it helps you to keep moving forward. You know, yeah. it's, as your sign says, as you know, as we yeah. all know, it ain't about how hard you can hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. Roz, I cannot get over how strong you are. Stacy, what say you?
You are the epitome of keep moving forward, keep punching. And you've just, you know, you hit these obstacles. You know, you got by the surgery for the cancer, and then you got hit with another surgery shortly after that. If it's okay, I can cut this mm-hmm. if you want me to. But, yes. you know, you were then hit with a bowel obstruction, which post- belly surgeries can happen because you can develop scar tissue and then you can develop a bowel obstruction. So sure. then there's another surgery that she had to overcome. I think one of my favorite moments is when, because of that, you missed your Chicago marathon and you were so down, and instead, didn't you sign up? You're like, okay, I'm not going this year, I guess. So I'll just sign up for next year. I just remember you signing wow. up. Yeah, I remember you signing up immediately. Like, you weren't even cleared to run yet. And you're like, I'm signing up for something. And that's it. And you signed up immediately for the next one. And I was just like, that is the can-do lesson that this movie series has infused into an entire generation. And you just, you're that. You're that in every way. I also want you to talk about the education you're going after, because you're taking all of this and you are getting certified or are certified. Tell me where you are on that right now.
Well, first of all, thank you so much for, like, you know, all the compliments and everything. Oh. I know I try to put up a strong front. Sometimes it looks easy, but it's not. Again, going back to Rocky and Adrian, it's like, you know, Adrian says it's okay to be afraid. And also Rocky says, like, you're not supposed to show your opponent how much you're afraid. You're supposed to put on this tough guy facade. Right. And so basically that's the way I treated it. Like, cancer was like another boxing opponent, and I wasn't going to let it know how much, like,
I was afraid.
But since I was down a lot, like, I had a lot of downtime, I decided to enroll in a course through, it's called ACE, it's American Council of Exercise. And I started taking health coaching classes because, again, like, you know, fitness is now become my passion, and I want to help other people get to their goals, because I feel that being in, like, losing all that weight helped me push forward through these other obstacles. Like, a part of me was like, why did I bother to lose all this weight if I was going to have all these surgeries and I was going to have all these health conditions? But I feel that if I wasn't in the shape that I was in now, I probably wouldn't have been able to bounce back so quickly.
Agreed. I'm just going to say that. I swear to God, had you not lost the weight and gotten in really phenomenal shape, who knows where that would have taken you.
Right. And I'll tell you, that is 100% true, because the healing people, obese patients are at higher risk for everything, anesthesia risks, healing risks. So the weight loss actually was part of preparation in a way to be more successful through that.
I definitely think that. Had an angel on my shoulder, because I did all of that beforehand, which got me prepared for this, the Bane event.
The bigger. Oh my God.
Yeah.
Could you imagine not even knowing all that time, you know?
Exactly.
That maybe that was the bigger reason behind all that weight loss. You even offered it to me, because I mean, I'm constantly struggling with 25 pounds. It's just, that's just where I live. It's very frustrating. And I know you and I were going to start talking a little bit about nutrition and fitness. And I still want to do that.
That's exactly, like, I got the health coaching certification, which will basically, I can be an accountability partner and help, read food labels or, any kind of confusing questions, because, you know, talking with doctors is not clear. Like, you have to speak their language almost. And it's like, it's hard work, but I feel I have all this knowledge and I want to be able to share it with people. Mm-hmm. And I just feel like that's the best way to go, like, for me. Mm-hmm. And I'm excited. Like, I still want to take, like, a nutrition class, and I still want to take a personal training class. But, like, the health coaching is, like, a broad, general kind of thing. Plus, two, you know, I have a lot of anecdotal evidence, but now I also have, like, some book knowledge, too, to go with it.
Right.
Yeah. Nice.
Yeah.
And I want to remind people, too, that, you know, modern medicine, these doctors, which is very surprising, do not have one day, and Roz and I have talked about this, do not have one class on nutrition. So just know that everything you put in your mouth, food is also a medication. Everything you eat is also a medication.
And yeah.
It all starts with food. It all starts with your diet. And it just is stunning to me how educated these doctors are, but they don't have the one thing we have to do every day.
Exactly.
Feed ourselves, right? Like, what? How is that even, is that even the case? It just makes me crazy.
Roz, I got to ask. Yo, I love the shirt you're wearing.
Yes, I was going to say.
So I have a couple of questions. One, Was it a Win Rozzy Win shirt or was it a Nike shirt first?
Well, it was a Nike shirt first. But
okay, but go ahead.
Okay, our good friend Rick Babcock.
Yes!
Made it for me!
Yay!
That's where I was going.
I reached out to him because I, what can I control? I can control what I put in my mouth and I can control my exercise, right? When life throws everything at me, those are the things I can control. So I signed up, like Stacy said, I signed up to run my first marathon in Philadelphia this year in November, November 19th.
Beautiful.
Nice.
Yeah. Yeah.
So where did you get the Nike shirt? Where did you find that?
I bought the Nike shirt at a place called Dick's Sporting Goods.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And then I contacted Rick through DMs on Instagram and I said, hey, if I send you this shirt, can you do it? And he was like, yeah, sure. Of course. No problem. And I mailed it out to him and God, his turnaround is super quick. Yeah. So
I love it. Yeah. Love
it. He sent it back to me like a week later. Like as soon as he got the shirt, he already sent me a picture and he was like, okay, this is what I'm thinking. You know, do you like it before I press it? And I was like, yes, we're good. So
total turnaround time with Rick was about what? Total. From the time you mailed it till you got it back.
Well, okay. Like it wasn't Rick. It was the post office. So he mailed it out right away.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, yeah.
I mean, he probably did it within like 48 hours that he put it like back in the mail.
Right.
And
it was the post office that dropped the ball.
Yeah. Yeah, that's neither here nor there because they're always dropping the ball.
Exactly. You know,
Santa, and I know this for a fact, Santa does not get the letters. You got to have an eight-week lead time on Santa letters. Yeah, because it's crazy. I have a friend that works at the North Pole. Long story short, 8 weeks is the minimum. So, I mean, what Rick does is amazing. I'm telling you guys, you got to look him up.
I love that. I noticed that.
You absolutely do. So I'm definitely going to be wearing this, especially in the summer when I start my training. So
nice. Here's some more pictures. You sent me some pictures. Let's go through those. Nice. Got this. Love.
Yeah. Somebody, look at that.
Is that you sent me that one, right? Is that the one?
Yes.
Yes.
I sent you this one. This is me in Austin, Texas. They have like a long hiking and biking and running trail. Mm-hmm. And so that's just me like on the trail one Saturday morning representing.
Nice.
Yeah. And then Mike and I on our tour. Yeah.
Oh, what a great time we had.
Yeah, it was a blast. And then again, like that, like I had to send it because like I said, with everything that I was going through, this was before I even knew I was going to go through it. And I was paying my respects to Adrian's grave and Polly.
And, yeah, you were.
Now just like looking back at it, it was just like, oh.
Yeah. It's so funny. It's almost like a creepy little forecast. You know what I mean?
It was.
Like.
And then of course in front of Mighty Mix Gym, I'm so glad I was fortunate enough to go before
I know
all the fencing and the changes and everything like that.
Yeah. Now you had the coolest idea on earth about creating a Rocky fitness bubble. I want you to share that.
It was something I was thinking about because I always, if I can't make it to Philadelphia for the Rocky run, I like to do it virtually because the swag is just spot on. As you can see behind me, I've got like my my Rocky Run shadow box.
I'm going to pull that up. There we go.
There you go.
Yeah.
And so basically I like to do the run and they have it. And if you can't make it to Philadelphia, they do a virtual run. So I was thinking of starting like an Instagram group or a Facebook group or Instagram or just somewhere if people are interested and wanting to get all of us in the Rocky bubble to like do the Rocky run and everybody post pictures of them in their shirts and like, you know, just getting active. You don't even have to run it. Like you could totally walk it. You can like do your own pace, your own time, because it's just important for us to just get out there in nature and just enjoy, the environment.
Move.
Yeah,
be
just
active.
Move. Exactly. Exactly. So, you know, I was kind of wanting to start like, because when you sign up, they're like, oh, you want to be a team captain or you want to start a team. And so I had asked Stacy, like, would it be okay if I did like Team Rocky files? Like, I think, yes, you know, that would be fun.
Absolutely. So what is the name of the app? Was there a specific app? Or
I'm using an app called Strava.
Okay,
and that's so, you know, if y'all want to download the app, I can start a group in there. Or if you don't want another app on your phone, that's fine too. We can do, you know, a Facebook group message or a group, you know, thing, or, you know, however, you know, if anybody's interested, you know, I just kind of want to get an idea of who would be down first, you know, before I start, like, you know, taking the ball and running with it. Okay. But I just think it would be a great idea for all of us to be posting on the same day of the run and just, you know, everybody in their shirts and, you know, little Instagram videos and stuff like that. Like, I just think that would be cool.
That's awesome. Yeah. You know what? We'll do a post. We're going to put together info about Strava and just do a post and just, you know, get the level of interest, you know, see what people think, and then we can go from there. But I loved that idea because it'll you know, we don't have the luxury of everyone being in the same neighborhood or the same town.
Exactly.
So it's a nice way to get us connected in another way. So I love that idea. So
exactly. Awesome. And I loved your pictures of you and Melissa getting together in Nashville. Like, that was so cool.
We had a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun. She is a funny, funny woman. She's naturally funny. She could, I'm telling you, I'm like, she could do stand up. She's a funny, funny woman. So
talk about life. And dating. Her stories on speed dating are hilarious.
Yes.
Wow.
Definitely recommend if you have not seen Melissa Gilmore's episode. She's a lot of fun.
Definitely.
Roz, I can't thank you enough. I was so excited that you were willing to come on and share everything that you've gone through, because it's not been fun. You know what I'm saying? But you've just come out victorious, and I'm like, we have a whole nother story now because of 2022, and it's Adrian month and it's women. And I had to have you back on. So you're just amazing. Just keep doing what you're doing. And, you know, we message each other in the background, and I've said to you, and I know we talked about this, but I want to talk about it here, that, you know, you don't know my writing. Remember when you and I were talking and you were like, all those posts that you do remind people of what their dreams are. You know what I'm saying? So even though your post is about running or cancer or whatever their goal is, somebody might be a writer or a singer or whatever. So it's not about the thing. You're reminding people of that thing they put on the back burner. And I had to message you that day because there was just something about that one particular post that reminds me, I am not taking the time to do that one big thing that I want to do most. And so you don't know who you're inspiring. So even if you think it's sort of an innocuous post or whatever, you don't know how it's going to hit. And so just keep posting and keep showing everything, the good days, the struggle days. It helps people to keep going. And I love your posts. I love your posts. So absolutely.
Thank you so much. You're welcome. That. Because always I just think I'm doing it for me.
Say that again,
Mike. I was just saying that it was like, I mainly do it for me, but knowing that like I can help other people makes me feel good. Like,
it's a purpose.
That's what I'd like to do.
It's a purpose that drives you.
Yes.
I get it.
Exactly.
I get it.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah,
don't ever shy away from that.
And Chad is even, he's running now. He's losing weight.
It's amazing.
They're like going to be the fittest couple we know.
I'm telling you. As a matter of fact, Chad is probably going to be washing his shirts on Roz's abs. like a rock. Okay?
Yes.
Yeah. One more thing. I didn't get the elevator question because I know I answered it before. But
go.
Roz, at this point in your life, if you were alone in an elevator with Sylvester Stallone for 30 seconds, what would you say?
I would like to thank him because not only did he help me reach my fitness inspiration, but him and the character of Adrian that he wrote and Rocky have also inspired me and helped me beat cancer. So he helped me twice.
Twice! That's amazing.
Yep, and he always says that Rocky is his imaginary best friend. Well, Rocky and Sly are my imaginary best friends.
I love it.
Oh, Roz.
I agree wholeheartedly.
Oh my God, she's the sweetest. Just the sweetest. I love you so much.
No,
you such a Stacey, we have to have like a virtue, like a virtual tissue box.
That yeah.
We yeah. Like,
you know, like, yeah. I know, right?
Yeah.
But you too. Thank you for creating this Rocky bubble. I've met so many
the best
amazing
thing in the world
because of it.
Oh, I'm so
best
happy.
Best thing in the world.
So exactly. Happy. Thank you, Roz.
Thank Roz. We'll
Thank
get
you.
Back very soon again, and we'll see what's been happening and how far you're progressing.
Sounds great.
Okay.
Bye,
keep Roz. Punching.
Keep punching.
Bye.
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 Love.
She's on fire.
Love. She's just she's an unstoppable force. That's what I've learned, you know. And I felt that when we interviewed her the first time, and then,
yep.
You know, a lot of the stuff she's been going through is medical, so we. Talked a lot more, and I'm happy for her to call me. Anything I can do to put people's minds at ease, you
oh,
know.
Gotcha.
And so she's just like, okay, this is what I got to do. This is what I'm facing, and
that's it.
I'm okay. It's like she doesn't give herself a choice. Giving up is not a choice,
right.
You know. She's just gonna let's do it. It's gonna
yep.
suck, but let's do it. You know.
Time for fear will be later.
The right.
Sadness and the shock and the. All
yeah.
that later. Right now, we got to work pronto.
Right.
Because if you're going to get cancer, stage one. Let
yeah.
that, hey, that's great. Stage
yeah.
one. Okay.
Right.
We can work with that. We can kick its ass and get it out.
Right. Right. And she said, and I'll be posting, she sent me a little video too. And she said in that video, she said, listen to your bodies, people.
Yeah.
If you just, you know your own body, you know something's just not right. You know what I mean? And it's not like they're going to volunteer to do all this testing for you. Sometimes you've got to push. You've
yeah.
got to be your own advocate when you are in that office saying, I am not right. And I want this testing. And as a nurse for 30 years, I can tell you the patient has to be the one to push. So if you feel something's not right, you got to go speak up. You got to be the squeaky wheel, which is hard for some people because that's not our nature a lot
yeah,
of times,
right.
you know. But until they can answer the question, you keep pushing for the testing that you need. That's all I can
well
say.
Well said, Stacey. Well said.
So, my friend, I think my closeout comments, first of all, are to your parents. Happy
okay.
birthday to both of them. I want you to send me a picture because I want to send them a happy birthday post. I'm going to put them.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to put them up. So send me a nice picture of the both
yeah.
of them from the weekend or something. Reading their newspapers.
Yeah, I got one that my mother has on her Facebook page.
Nice.
Yeah, it's a family one, but it's mom and dad's up front, and then it's all of us in the background. But it's a great picture, and
yeah.
so I'll send that to you.
Send
so you can,
that. Send
that
because
up.
People love your parents, and they should. I know that they would want the opportunity to say happy birthday to your parents, so I do want to do a post for them. Yeah.
Well, and they, you know, they have great compassion and understanding for dealing with me. Oh yeah.
They're
it's
good.
A lot.
They're
it's
adorable.
A lot.
And then I just want to send everybody over to Lorenzo's page. Girl Scout cookies are for sale and they do
ah,
it all,
there you
yeah,
go.
They do it all electronically now. And I bought from him last year and you just go on there, tell him what, and they mail right to you. So his daughter's
nice.
Name is Jazzy and all the information will be on his page. If you like your Girl Scout cookies, head that way.
Beautiful.
That's it. What about you, Michael?
What about me? Okay, I wrote a little book called Cue the Rocky Music. Not bad. You can find it anywhere books are sold and specifically on Amazon. Check it out, people. Not a lot of big words in it. There's a little movie out called The Pretender, which is if you are in North America, it is for free on YouTube. And if you're not in North America, there's a whole bunch of links. Go to the link in bio. You will see it on my page, the Yo Rocky Philly Film, Yo Philly Rocky Film Tour on Instagram. The Pretender, great little movie. Stacey, where can people
movie.
Find you?
I am on Instagram at HadMeAtYo and on at The Rocky Files and on Facebook at The Rocky Files Podcast.
Beautiful.
And that is episode 64.
64. My God. 65? We're going to have to do something seriously impressive for that. I don't know what we're going to do.
I do.
Okay, well, I can't wait to hear. Stacey, I will see you next week.
See you next week. Take it easy.
Bye, buddy. Keep punching, everybody.
Keep punching. Bye, guys.